Okay, we are here on day two of our super casual game jam where we are making a game in 2 days, and we just finished implementing authentication using PlayFab. So we're going to first demo the game, and then we're going to go through the code to explain how we did it. So let's take a look. Here is the login page. We have a create account. You can play as a guest. You could switch to login if you have an account. So let's create an account, username, email address, and password. Doesn't look like much from this end of things, but we are now logged in and we can go ahead and play the game under this account. So this enables us to do a few things, like we could show up the username that we picked on a leaderboard. We can log into this game from multiple different devices. So if I wanted to have this on my computer and play here and then go somewhere on my phone, I could basically just like open the app and start playing the same game that I left off. Another thing that we can do is use Unity's saving system to basically, once we create an account or log in, we can just keep ourselves logged in so we don't have to log in every time, and the save will basically persist wherever we are. So not much has been done to the game other than that, but we do have PlayFab working, so let's go over how we did that and then we can look at the rest of it. So here is the PlayFab script that we're using. PlayFab was installed yesterday into Unity, and in order to use it in our script, we have the namespace using PlayFab and using PlayFab client models. I then have I've serialized some text fields. Let me show exactly what those are linking up to. So I have an input on our title screen here. So I'm going to close this overlay. And on the input here, this is not the placeholder, but the actual text that you start typing in when you're inputting something in the field. This is what we want to get because that's what you're going to type here, and that's what's going to be fed into our script here. So we have our signup name, we have our signup email, our signup password, and then I have one for login email and login password. Then I also have this here for creating the account and logging in, and these buttons are all linked up to this code, but the one in login to switch back to create account didn't work. So let's do that now. Switch to create account. That should fix that issue we saw. So that's how this is set up. We have those, we input them in our inspector over here on our script once we've attached it to this part of the project. Signup name, as you can see here, it correlates to those text fields. Well, not the field, but the actual text within the input field. And then we have these pieces, these game objects, which are like panels that show these fields. So I switch between them if you're logging in versus signing up. Once I click the button login or create account, the first time I did it, it created an account. I didn't do anything, so I pressed the button again and got an error that account already exists because it created the account but nothing showed up to the user. So, and I was allowed to click it again with all the same stuff. So instead we now have, once you click a button, you can't click it again because it should take you to the next thing as long as everything works out. And here we have title controls. So our other script where we start the game happening once we've logged in. On register, we have register request, var register request, new register PlayFab user request. And this is where we put in the email from the text that we have up here. Sign up email text password. We have sign up password.txt and the username sign up name.txt. And so from there we can use PlayFab client API, register PlayFab user, and then we have register user request. And if it's successful, we go over here to, in my console, it will say that it was successful. And we have the failed output, which here it will just say failed. Once we want to make this a little bit more user-friendly, we can give the player information on why it failed. I'm also going to want to make sure that we can click the button again if our sign up or login fails. So I'm going to have to fix that in a minute and implement some feedback to the player if they, didn't have a proper email address or if they have too short of a username, anything like that. We want to give that information back to the player. And similarly here we have a login with email address request, and then we input the login email text and the login password text, and then with those we can get the request login with email address, and then we have the login success, login failed. Here's the success, here's the failed. And what I'm going to probably want to do here is switch this down here so that our login success, we don't need to press it again. We're logged in. We're about to start the game. Let's do that over here because if we don't log in properly, we don't want to start the game. So let's fix that up a bit. Let's do the same thing. Actually, you know what? Let's do, if you've started the game, let's not do this again, but let's only set it to true if it's successful. So we set it to successful here. Start a game is true. Then we start the game. That way we don't click this multiple times. And then here we do the same thing for register. And we only start it if it's successful. There we go. And if we are logged into our account on PlayFab, we can see here that the two users, and if I refresh and clear, we'll see three users because I just made one as I'm demoing here. Doesn't usually take this long. They're there. So we see three of them here, right here in Canada. And we had the last two we made and a new one here. And I think that's pretty much all we need to do to be able to log in. Login. Yeah. And then we just have the switching between the two, login versus sign up. So that's it for getting authentication set up with PlayFab. And we're going to keep working through the game, and then we can start doing things like leaderboards, analytics, online saving, all kinds of stuff that we can use with this. So we have our credit account. We have our login. We're going to log in with our secret login information. Here we are. Character's already started. Great. That's wonderful. There she is, picking up some resources, scavenging through the city. And we have our building she can go into. She can sleep to restore her health. This was not difficult to do, and there's the very large oversized bed is totally intentional, not hiding little things that came up that we didn't have time to fix. But you know what? Not bad. It's not bad. It works. That's what's important. We got a big bed out of it. Extra cozy. This was tricky getting from one level to the next, telling her where to walk, clicking, but I think it turned out really good. I'm so happy with that. It's cool to go through these buildings. If we had more time or if I choose to continue working on it, I would love to fill in these buildings so that they have like really interesting little areas you can go and explore and find items. Right now we just have this pile of rubble that you can search through, but I think it'd be really cool if there were like shelves that the character could open and you could maybe find something. If there were items that you didn't have to search for, so you'd be like, oh good, I don't have to waste time searching, which, you know, uses up health. We also, underneath where I am here, we have our inventory system. So these are our hotkeys. When you pick something up, it goes to our hotkey place here. We have nails, chips, wooden board. So another thing that would be cool to add, another feature would be to upgrade areas. Another one would be to have raiders come in, like in the full game. So this is actually using assets I created for my main project, Strain. One of the characters and some of the buildings, and actually I don't know if we used the buildings from Strain, but we used a few things from Strain that I made before, and so this is kind of like a mini prologue game. Strain is a normal first person 3D game, but this 2.5 style I think turned out really cool. But yeah, it'd be cool to have raiders like we have in the full game. It'd be cool to have more items. It'd be cool to do upgrades and crafting that we could definitely add in down the road. It'd be cool to turn this into basically a mobile version of Strain, like a simplified one, where we tell a little backstory of a different character who we see in the main game. I think that would look really cool, and that would work out really well. I'd also love to do procedural buildings. This is a static level. The reason I opted for that was because of the nav mesh. I knew that the nav mesh would be difficult to do procedurally. So because we were on a limited timeline, I didn't do that. Same with day-night cycle, would be tricky. Not that tricky, but you know, a little bit of extra work. We got wooden planks. Also, we can zoom in and out, which is kind of neat. Some things would be nicer to polish up, like it's not clear that you can interact with different things until you click on them. So that's not obvious, but it'd be nice to make that a little bit more obvious. Same with when we use an item, it's not clear that we used it other than the fact that our health bar goes up. So stuff like that. Audio would be nice to add in, but I think we did a pretty good job for the time that we had. I'm pretty happy with it, and I'd love to keep working on it in the future. As for PlayFab, some features that would work really well would be a leaderboard. So either most area uncovered or most days survived, but it would need to be day-night cycle would need to be there, so we would count days, or even longest time survived. Something like most raiders defended against, or we could even have high score for best base upgrades, and we could have like values for different parts of the base and how much each upgrade is worth, so we could have like numeric system of which is the best base. I would love to do the saving through PlayFab so that we could have, we don't have saving yet, but saving through PlayFab so that we could play this on our PC and then log in. Well, not even log in, once we log in one time on our phone, we could just open it on our phone, carry on from where we left off in the game. We could even add dialogue with different characters that we made in Strain that I think would be really neat to add in. The ideas are endless. We could also get analytics from the game. That would be nice to see. How people play the game, where they stop playing, what might be indicators of where it starts getting boring, and that would be a great way to start making the game better and optimizing for a better experience. We could also add in-game purchases. I don't know, maybe some skins or something like that would be cool, or like basically DLCs through PlayFab, if that's even a thing that people would want. Something like skins or visual stuff might be better. And if I was feeling really adventurous, we could also do multiplayer one day down the road. That would be pretty neat. But I think for a two-day jam, we got a really cool game done. Thank you guys for joining along, everyone in the stream. That is it for our game jam. Have a wonderful day, everyone. Bye-bye, guys.